Hello students, welcome to SV Technology. In this video, we are going to discuss COA subject, second unit, very important question for BTech second year students. That is data transfer and data manipulation instructions. Generally, in computer organization and architecture, the computer instructions are classified into three categories. The first category is data transfer instructions, and the second category is data manipulation instructions, and the third category is program control instructions. So we will see each and every type of category in detail with the list of instructions supported in particular category. If you are watching my channel for the first time, please do subscribe my channel and support me. So coming to data transfer instructions. So the name itself saying that data transfer, these instructions are used to transfer the data from one place to another place in our computer. Or we can say that the data transfer instructions are used to transfer the data from one component to another component. So all the data will be transferred in the form of binary, you know that already. The common transfers between memory and processor registers, and between processor registers and input output, and between processor register and themselves. Simply, in general terms, the transfers may occur between the memory and processor, and the processor and memory or input output devices, or the transfer may be between two or more processes. So this is what here I am explaining is data transfer instructions are going to transfer the data between memory, processor and input output devices in simple terms. So we will see what are the list of data transfer instructions here. So mainly we have 7-8 data transfer instructions. Those are, first one is load, it will be represented with LD. Second is store, it is represented with ST. Third one is move, it is represented with MOV. And fourth one is exchange, that is XCH. Next one, input, which is represented as in. Output, which is represented as out, and push represented as push, and pop represented as pop. So these are the instructions we have in data transfer instructions. These instructions are used to transfer the data between memory to processor, or processor to input output devices, or memory or processors itself. Here we will discuss about each and every instruction. What is the responsibility of that instruction? We will see here. The first instruction is the load instruction, has been used mostly to designate a transfer from memory to a processor register, usually an accumulator. So in simple terms, load register is used to load any data into processor register. So that processor registers 90% accumulator we use most of the times. Sometimes we use other processor registers also. The second operation or the second instruction is the store instruction. It is used to transfer the data from processor register to memory. The earlier load is used to memory to processor, and now the store is used to processor to memory. So these both are quite opposite operations. Next, the third operation is move operation or move instruction. It is used in computers with multiple CPU registers to designate transfer between one register to another register. So as we know that we have so many registers in our computer, like DR data register, INP input register, OUT output register, and TR temporary register, and BR base register. Like this we have so many registers. The move instruction is used to transfer the data between computer register. So mostly we have 10 to 15 types of computer registers. If you want to transfer the data between these registers, DR, TR, AR, all these, we use MOV operation. It will be represented with MOV. The next operation, fourth operation, is exchange. So simply, exchange is an operation which performs swapping between two registers. So the register A has some contents and the register B has some contents. If you want to swap A content to B and B content to A, you are going to use exchange instruction. So this will be represented with XCH. And the next two instructions are input and output instructions. This instruction is used to transfer data among processor register and input output terminals. You know that in input output organization or input output configuration, we have discussed about this input output terminals. So these input and output commands or instructions are used to transfer the data between this input output devices and processor registers. The next two instructions are push and pop instructions. These are used in zero address registers or zero addressing mode. So we will discuss about zero addressing mode in next classes. Here, the push pop instruction transfer data between processor register and memory stack. So in stack, we can perform only inserting deletion operations using push and pop instructions. So here, different types of computer uses different types of addressing modes. So based on that addressing mode, these operations have to perform. So simply, here I am going to give some assembly level conversions to different addressing mode. You know, already we have discussed about addressing mode in last class. In that addressing mode, we have discussed the 10 types of addressing modes. In that 10 types of addressing mode, I am going to represent here few types of addressing modes along with this data transfer operations. So here in direct addressing mode, we are going to perform LD ADR operations, which means LD means load, ADR means memory address into accumulator. So most of the data transfer operations are going to be performed on accumulator, as we said. So here I have given example of all addressing modes along with example. Please do refer this. Data manipulation instruction. The name itself saying that data manipulating. To manipulate the data, we need some instruction. Those instructions are called data manipulation instructions. So the difference between the data transfer instruction and manipulation instruction is, in data transfer instruction, the data is going to be transferred from one place to another place, or one component to another component, or one register to another register, but the content, whichever the data is there, it won't change anything. But in data manipulation instruction, the data is going to be changed based on the operation which we perform, based on the instruction which we have used. So we will see what are the data manipulation instructions and types and symbols, everything here. So data manipulation instruction perform operations on data provided in computational capabilities for each computer. So here, what is computational capabilities means? It can change the data, it can manipulate the data, okay, it can rearrange the bits, all these things happen. So mainly these data manipulation instructions are three types, as we know, micro operations, right? So same instructions will be here. What are the micro operations we have? Arithmetic micro operations, logical micro operations, shift micro operations. Same here, coming to instruction, arithmetic instructions, logical and bit manipulation instructions, and shift instructions. So we will discuss each and every category in detail with the list of instruction that category have. So coming to arithmetic instructions. So as you know already, arithmetic instructions are used to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and డివిజన్ ఆపరేషన్స్. సో మోస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ద కంప్యూటర్స్ యూజ్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఆపరేషన్స్. మోస్ట్ కంప్యూటర్ ప్రొవైడ్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్ ఫర్ ఆల్ ఫోర్ ఆపరేషన్స్. సమ్ స్మాల్ కంప్యూటర్ హ్యావ్ ఓన్లీ ఎడిషన్ అండ్ పాసిబిలీ సబ్స్ట్రాక్షన్ ఇన్స్ట్రక్షన్స్. ద మల్టిప్లికేషన్ అండ్ డివిజన్ మస్ట్ be generated by means of software subroutines. So I will discuss about subroutines also in next class, don't worry about that. So coming to arithmetic operations, what are the arithmetic operations we have? So in our COA mostly we have 8 to 9 arithmetic operations. So first one is increment operation, which is called INC and which is used to which is used to add 1 to the value stored in the register. Suppose I said that INC of AC, what is the meaning of that? Whatever the content is present in AC accumulator register, that will be incremented with 1. That incremented number will be next address. Next, decrement means it is going to decrease 1, which is decrement arithmetic operation. Next, add, which is used to add two operands, one is augend and second one is addend. Next, subtract is an operation which is used to subtract two operands, and multiply, which is used to multiply, divide, which is used to divide, and next one very important, add with carry. Whenever you are doing addition operation, carry will be generated and that will be given to next successor addition. So then the two operands will become three operands including carry. For that we use ADDC and subtract with borrow, and negation or two's complement is these are the arithmetic instructions in data manipulation instructions. For each one I have given example here, please do screenshot this one and read. So these are about arithmetic instructions in our COA. So next, coming to logical or bit manipulation instructions, these instructions are performed to the binary bits of our registers, or in simply logical instruction perform binary operations on strings of bits stored in registers. They are useful for manipulating individual bits or group of that represent binary coded information. BCD form we call it. About BCD form in future classes we are going to learn. So the logical instructions consider each bit of the operand separately. Means suppose it has 8 bits, it perform operation on each bit. Okay. So coming to logical or bit manipulation operations, we have following operations. Total 10 operations we have. One is clear, which is used to clear the entire register, means the content of register will be replaced by 0. Okay. So next, complement. So what is complement? COM. COM means complement, which produces one's complement by inverting all bits of the operand. Suppose the bit, the operand has 1010, after performing complement it will be 0101. Like this it will perform complement operation, inversion operation. And next, three operations are very important operations, and OR, XOR produce the corresponding logical operations on individual bits of the operands. You know that already what AND gate will do and what OR gate will do and what XOR gate will be do, and all these operations will be performed corresponding instruction. So the logical instructions also be used performing bit manipulation operations. Coming to shift instructions, as name saying that shift instructions are used to perform shift operation on the binary bits. It may be either left shift or right shift. As we know in shift micro operations, the shift micro operations will be divided into three types. What are that? Logical, arithmetic and circular. Same thing will be repeated here. We will discuss, don't worry. So The bit shifted at the end of the word discriminate the type of shift used, and shift instruction may specify logical shift, arithmetic shift, and rotate type shift. This rotate type shift also called as circular shift here. So in that logical shift, we have logical shift left and logical shift right. In arithmetic, we have arithmetic shift right and arithmetic shift left. And rotate or circular shift, we have rotate shift right or circular shift right, and rotate shift left and circular shift left, and rotate right through carry and rotate left through carry. So these are the data manipulation instructions we have. So this is the class today. In next class, we will see what are the program control instructions and subroutine calls. So if you want the notes of this class, please do subscribe my channel and send a screenshot to my WhatsApp number, which is given in description. I will send the entire 5 units notes of COA and with important questions also. So for more classes like this, please do subscribe to my channel and support me. Yours, Mahesh, signing off.